Mother.
Just lather it on. How does it feel? Texture?
What is this?
I don't like it.
I'm scared.
Oh, it broke.
I broke it.
That'll put on. They're not plumping?
No.
Okay, thank God.
Whoa.
Forget social media. I'm dope in real life.
Oh my God. These I bought because they kicked me off the PR list after I told them I didn't like their lip liners.
What grandma purse is this?
PR.
I want to start every video just PR. Saying what we're doing like that. Hi guys, welcome to today's video. We are opening PR.
How exciting.
I'm boxes. Wearing a Jessica Simpson sweater from TJ Maxx.
Cause you know what?
TJ Maxx men's section is so boring.
Yeah.
I know, so I peruse the women's.
Yeah, and because you know we get Nautica polos.
Oh, totally, or black t-shirts with Calvin Klein right
and or the black and orange tie-dye with goosebumps on it.
Totally. We have a combination of PR as well as a bunch of stuff that I recently purchased from Ulta Beauty. This bag is empty. We're gonna let you know whether we think it's trash or whether we think it's worth it. Let's dive in.
Christ.
All right, first up, this is from Benefit.
And then mine is from Freck Beauty.
Which we were joking, my PR. Oh no.
Speaking of.
We were saying last the video where Casey did a PR unboxing where he ate the loose candy in the Freck thing was for Valentine's Day.
Freck.
And this is Valentine's Day.
Yeah. And here we go.
And he literally said, he was like, let me know if there's anything in there I can eat.
I will save this. So yes. This is Casey's pile over here. So we have a watermelon lollipop from Freck.
Yummy. So this is from Benefit. It looks like a drum for some reason. This is just their normal brow pencil. I think this one is new, right?
So they have the new brow gel. It's the Precisely My Brow Gel. And then they have the new ultra thin Precisely, what is it called?
Precisely My Brow Detailer. So this one is like a brow wax. And the detailer, this is supposed to be modeled literally after a like retractable pencil.
Almost like Huda.
Yes.
Yeah, where that micro millimeter pencil.
Which I don't know because Michaela reviewed this and she twisted it all the way up and she was going like this and it was wiggling back and forth. You and I opened this and I was doing it on my hand and it broke.
Well, we barely twisted it up and it's a very strategic. You almost have to go straight on with it. If you go at an angle, you're gonna snap it.
Yeah, so I wouldn't do that with this, but I do really like this if you have super thin brows, like to be able to get the most small little hair-like stroke. So I don't know, this is interesting, but yeah.
I'm excited because I tried the brow gel yesterday and I really loved it. It was like full coverage. It held my brows in place. Yeah, it had a lot of coverage to it, like Gimme Brow from them.
Mm-hmm.
But what was cool that the brush was a little bit more slim.
Yeah.
And it was a little bit longer than the Gimme Brow and it really gave you a lot of hold and
that's
a lot
nice.
Of color.
Because a lot of tinted don't give you a lot of hold.
Yeah, which I was impressed. So this launch excited me
that's
a lot.
That's great.
Freck Beauty, it doesn't look like we have really anything new. It looks like, oh, we have new lip liners. So in six shades. So those are new. And then we have the Makeout Club lipsticks, which these are not new. Oh, Rich Bitch, that goes after their serum here. There's now a peptide lip balm version of Rich Bitch. That's cool.
Did you see this lip liner? It's like wet.
Do they dry down maybe?
I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, so there's like a bunch of all nudes.
Mother.
Put the gloss on the mama. Just lather it on.
How does it feel? Texture?
Oil. Like water. Yeah. Really, really thin.
Ah.
Yeah, I don't know. You excited? That box alone, girl. Wow.
God. YSL PR packages in this
on another level.
Leather. Stunning. So I'm assuming this was for Valentine's Day. So it's their like gloss stick.
Which I have to say something.
These are nice.
Yes, but they're very expensive for what they are. And are there more shades of these?
Yeah.
So you know what always chaps my ass? You guys, if you're not new here, you know, whenever YSL sends me complexion, like foundations or concealers, they send me all
everything.
60 shades. What is the point of that? I can't swatch that. Give me three that are within my shade range. But then this,
lip
that
products.
I could swatch everything for everybody.
Have
let's send
10
four.
Shades.
Yeah, one of them being clear. I don't know about these guys. I've seen these people are like buying these. I think they're like viral.
The
I don't know.
The texture is nice, but not for the price point of $40
no.
or probably $45, if not more.
If you want to, you can, but I just think they're overpriced for what they are.
Yeah.
Then this is from Clio, which is like one of the biggest K-beauty brands. And the Kill Lash Mascara is probably my favorite mascara of all time. Then they sent me this eyeshadow palette, their Cushion Foundation. Ooh. And a highlighter. This inspired me to spend $200 on more K-beauty stuff so we can do like a full face of K-beauty. The eyeshadow palette seems nice. This highlighter, guys.
It looks like the Revlon skin lights.
No.
Oh.
It is so beautiful. I can't even tell you. And what I love about it is when the light isn't hitting it, it looks like you have nothing on. It is one of the most natural, beautiful highlighters. This is the champagne-y one, and it comes in a pink. I ordered the pink. And then there is a new cushion foundation, which their cushion foundations are great. This is the, I think the Kill Cover High Glow Cushion. So this is glowy. So maybe like you would love this, but I also ordered the one that they just came out with that's in the matte. So I'm super excited, but they're so blurring and stunning. I really want to dive into these. So Cleo, super excited.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Okay. We have a giant box of Polite Society, which, okay, that sucks. They sent me, I just bought this Polite Society foundation because it's going insanely viral. Fair C, and they sent me Fair Neutral. So, okay. But I'm actually wearing that right now, and I'm trying to like judge how I feel about it.
Ooh, this is the new palette in here. Okay.
What? It says do not open until February 20th.
Tomorrow.
Okay.
Ooh.
All right, we have, wow, oh my God, there's a lot of shades. Holy crap. So we have a lot of shades of these blush sticks.
Wow, glossy lip balms. So these are different than the lip plumpers. Okay. There's glossy lip balms.
Which shade do you want me to open?
Oh my God.
Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I'm curious because these are called sticks, but they're super,
they're little.
Whoa.
Forget social media, I'm dope in real life.
Oh my God. Oh, cute.
Oh, wow.
Wow, okay, it's almost like a whipped consistency. Okay, no, this is why these videos end up being 9 million years long, because I want to put everything on. So make sure throughout this process you comment down below, wait till the end, and comment down below everything you want us, me, etc. to try.
Like gloss lip balms?
Ooh, cool.
Very nice.
That'll put on. They're not plumping?
No.
Okay, thank God.
Well, I would buy it.
Wow, this feels really good.
This palette is, it's interesting. Like at first glance, I don't love it, but this is kind of cute.
Yeah, the eyeshadow palette, I received one during holiday. They seem a little dull.
Yeah, Santa knows when you're being a bitch.
Yeah. They seem dull. Am I wrong? Like the shimmer. Colors. Like yeah, the shimmer.
Oh, the shimmer, the formula is.
Yeah, I don't know about the Polite Society eyeshadows, so. Alrighty, now we have from Huda Beauty, this how. Walk into the room first.
It's giving Lizzo.
Yes.
Or it's the SpongeBob meme of the purse.
Yes.
Yeah.
Girl, they send me this in every, I'm not kidding you, for 3 years, I've gotten this same bag.
And with the little, the paper.
You know how we feel about that.
Gotta stop. What grandma purse is this? Wait, but it's like, so you gotta like dig in this way.
Ew.
Like, I gotta find my stuff.
Ew.
All right, Kapari.
This is the Kapari, the body. Yeah, that's cool. That's new.
This is really cool.
That's like a body shimmer.
Body mist, yeah.
And then this is the Glow Shield. It's like an oil for the skin. It's a dry oil. It doesn't feel gross. The shimmer is stunning. This is SPF 50. They 45. Came out with the Rose Gold in 45. And then I feel like they have a new shade.
A bronze.
A deep dark.
In 30.
Finally, for deeper skin tones. That would be stunning. And then Huda Beauty, we they just sent Kohl pencils in brown and black, a mascara. And then, honestly, the real talking point of this are these new creamy eyeshadow palettes. 90% of the palette is cream formulas, but not the way you think. Not like Patrick Ta, like cream.
Wet cream.
It's like these
cream to powder finishes.
Yeah.
Almost like a velvety kind of consistency.
Honestly, the payoff is very pretty and they feel super cool. I'm just curious, like what do you use? Like a brush?
So I would, here, let's just like real quick.
Cause like here, I'm gonna take a fluffy brush. Okay. But you know what's awesome about these is like when you put them on and blend them, they're like blurring because of the cream.
Yeah, because even going in on the color I swatched.
Let alone the shimmers in this because of the cream formula are like very, very
blinding
and beautiful. I know.
Wow.
I'm super interested. Like, I feel like this is a very innovative thing, which you know we're starved for that recently. So these are super fun. And this one's the brown, I believe. Yeah, neutral brown. And then the grayish.
I would like to see more colors.
Yeah.
A little bit more potency and a little bit more fun.
Which,
maybe.
Like, maybe in this formula, they haven't, like, they're still working on the bold colors.
And perfecting it.
So, yeah. But I definitely am intrigued by those. Wow. We have a She Glam. This is the Ember Rose.
She Glam. Ember Rose.
Ember.
Oh, Ember Rose.
E-M-B-E-R, right?
Oh, I was like,
She
Ember
Glam's
Rose.
Packaging is insane.
What is Ember Rose?
I couldn't tell you. Okay. I don't know if this is a collab or if I'm supposed to know what that is. Okay, we have three blushes.
It's like very like old school makeup kind of vibes. Oh, like a more of a berry. Oh my God, look at that.
Wow.
That reminds me of the House Labs, the acai berry color.
Wow,
this formula looks beautiful.
What is this?
I don't like it.
I'm scared.
Just because we just have a fake rose.
What is it?
Is it a
paper? I thought it was one of those blushes.
Oh, it broke.
I broke it. I thought this is the Ember Rose Burning Devotion. I thought it said rose budding color. And I was going to be like, I'm out. Guys, yeah. I'm just out. It literally doesn't say what product this is.
Okay. It looks like gloss.
All right. All right. Whoa.
Mama, full coverage gloss.
Okay, I think I need to shut up.
I know.
Shut my whore mouth.
Okay, we have lipsticks. Oh, look at this coverage.
I think I need...
Girl.
Wow.
Whoa, that is stunning.
Whoa.
This is the shade Passion. Wow. Okay, and then we have like a pink in Cherish You. Hmm. Beloved is a red, and Bliss looks like a... caramel brown.
This is like a, it says color palette. So let's see what that means. Open up to nothing.
Okay, four eyeshadow shades.
There's four different colors.
But like the colors are dull. That would be super cool if it was like.
But like what a cool little idea. Travel palette. I love the idea of that. The packaging, excellent.
They're always just doing cool pack, like thinking outside the box when it comes to like packaging and
but
stuff.
But that was, I will say that's a little disappointing.
Yeah. So that's the pink one in Passion.
So that is. Wow.
Everything and nothing. The feels bottom great. Of this is red. And then that's fully, oh, I'm lying, Kevin. Holy
wow,
tits.
With the gloss, this gloss over that.
All right, these lipsticks, man, holy crap, that's stunning.
So next up, we have two things from YSL. So we have the new addition to the Black Opium family. So this is the cherry, mm-hmm. I believe, right? I smelled this, it gives me a headache personally.
Yes.
Not really like.
Yeah, I feel like you either love that fragrance or you don't.
Yeah, cherry fragrances I'm usually not into. I don't really care for it. And then a waterproof version of their mascara. They came out with a blue version of this and it's actually really nice.
Nice.
Okay, so next up we have Fenty Beauty, Fenty Skin. Over here, this way, are the two lip masks. And then we have the... So the new one, the Kalahari Melon, mm-hmm. which is the green one that we tried that we weren't really a fan
of. It's a little fakey candy.
The vanilla one is in there, though.
Yes,
the love the vanilla. The Kalahari Melon lip oils. Have you tried their lip oils before?
Yes, I love them. Nice, okay.
They're so good. And then the glosses, they finally brought back Fuchsia Flex, which isn't this the color that you wore on the podcast over that dark lip?
Yes,
now it's permanent. So they have it again now. So now it's permanent.
I wore that lip on, I think, the final episode with the champagne explosion.
It was.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, now from Kiss, Salon Extend Soft Gel System. And it seems like it even comes with a light.
Oh.
And then they came out with a glue-off instant, like, fake nail remover.
Oh.
That's kind of cool. So
Kiss is always out here.
I know.
Coming out with innovations.
So you put this, apply remover, lift with chisel tip, and buff the residue. So it takes, like, I'm right. Right now I'm wearing press on, but with glue, fake nails that I just filed down to like guy length, which we've talked about on the podcast. And this is a remover. I love that because sometimes they are stubborn. Okay, this is from the brand Tinted, and this is a SPF tint. Oh, Tinted 50.
Yeah, that actually feels pretty
good. Oh, okay. Yeah, shade 9. I don't know about that. For me.
That actually might work for you.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That's gorgeous.
Wow, that feels really nice. Okay, and then a brightening setting powder. Interesting. From NYX.
I love anything bright orange or bright pink.
Yeah.
So this was for the Super Bowl.
Yes. Oh no, oh no.
Can you close your eyes? Did you open this?
No. Oh no.
We have new drinking glasses. Classy. Mm-hmm. Disposable camera, kind of cool.
Cute.
Where am I getting that developed in 2024? What the duck? Is there any makeup in here?
Oh, probably in there.
So they sent over like...
The duck plump shades.
The duck plump shades and like some neutrals, a berry, the cherry spice one, which is new, sheer red. And then they have like the full coverage ones.
Yes. And I just have to say shit like this, and I know they probably make it for 2 cents, but it cracks me up because it's like when brands like NYX want to work with you, these are the brands that tell you they have no budget. And then
you have foam fingers.
Made. This, like, so...
This should be the thumbnail. This feels like I'm posing with the pitchfork. It's like the husband and wife just...
Alrighty, and then I have purchased from Ulta. LA Girl has been launching some new stuff, and I gotta give LA Girl credit. I feel
girl.
Like they're always kind of ahead of like everybody else when it comes to season. Like they come out with spring stuff before everybody else. This is the Desert Glow Envy palette, and the pigment on this is stunning. Such a fun range of colors for spring. I also got, this is the Bouncy Blush and Highlighter, both very pretty. There's one shade of blush and one shade of bronzer, which is not the tea. And then I also got these shimmery like lip glosses, which we were joking around. Normally we don't love, but I wanted to try these because I do like things like this over dark lip shades. And these are only $4.99. So that kind of justified, you know, doing it.
The last box here, I think, of House Labs, the new PhD lip glazes. We have it in six shades. And then they sent over, I guess, corresponding Le Monster lip crayons to put underneath it if you want more pigment.
We talked about these on Purchase or Pass on a recent episode. I don't know if it's out yet, but
I like the formula.
Yes, I in the beginning of the video was wearing Guava. These are kind of a hybrid, which I give House Labs credit when they jump on a train. Like everyone loves the lip oil train. They always kind of do up it. So these are hybrids where it's the infusion of the lip oil, pigment of a lip gloss, and a lip balm. So it's like three different things in one. I will say the colors are very like your lips, but better. But let me know if you want me to like swatch all them if you're interested in that. So then we have the new blushes and bronzers from REM Beauty, which these I bought because they kicked me off the PR list after I told them I didn't like their lip liners. I got sent this stuff from Flower Beauty, which I feel like has been pretty quiet for the past couple of...
For a while.
For a while, girl. We have their liquid blushes, a liquid highlighter. Weren't these...
Deceiving.
Girl, the outside does not match their color.
Especially the lightest color in the shade peachy.
Yes. So you see how light this one is here, and then you put it on.
And it's...
It's a lot darker. These two match... The perfectly. Color. So I hate that because you don't know what color you're getting if you can't swatch it. But the formula does seem very pretty. And then we have, I think these are new. These are their Kohl pencils in black and brown. And then the star for me is I open these. And these are the new Bright-Eyed Under Eye Corrector. I was using this one. I've been using it for a couple days in the shade light. Guys, this is so beautiful. And I'm maybe going to make people mad, but I'm sorry. These kick this, the NYX stick. Ass for under the eyes. I think these are super nice on the face, but everyone's putting these under the eyes and they look so heavy. This looks like nothing. I'm gonna make a short about it, so stay tuned.
Yeah, because you have this on now.
That's what I have only under my eyes.
You haven't set.
I know.
Stunning. You haven't even said it, and it's been on for quite a while.
I know. Miss Barrymore.
Yeah. Okay, so then last but not least, we have the new launches from REM Beauty.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually bought these yesterday, too, and so did you, which is so funny. So I'm wearing two of the blushes and a bronzer
Same
now.
Same cycle.
Sisters. So I will say the only thing deceiving about the swatches are the bronzers specifically. There are six shades of the bronzer. I'm wearing the lightest one now, sent to voicemail.
Mm-hmm.
And then the next shade is Out of Office. No, I'm sorry.
That.
Solar Storm. And then the shade, I think there's a shade in between.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's this shade. When you open these up, they look so warm versus the swatches that are so cool toned and so alarming.
And they look on the website. I even thought it was like, oh, there's really not like a dark enough dark shade. On the website, they look lighter than they are. In person, they're all like a shade darker than they are. But the formula, y'all, the blushes, this is the shade Nebula. We have Sun Pop.
Pinking of You.
And Skinny Dipped. These are very similar to the formula of the House Labs blushes. This is Dragon Fruit Days, which everybody loves. This is dead in the middle of this and this, but the formula is almost exactly the same.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's kind of stupid of House Labs, like we've always been saying, that these are like limited edition. They're gone now, and now they're going to come back soon. But here's this market gap now where a brand came out with almost the exact same creamy, beautiful, blurring formula for half the price.
The only thing about this that I was a little disappointed in was the tools. So I think it's a little unnecessary.
Yes.
Based on the photo of the blush and bronzer brush, the bronzer brush looked too dense, and then the blush brush looked interesting, but also too dense.
Yes.
And I used it today to apply my blush, and I thought it was actually going to be more rounded, like the Half Magic brush, but this one comes to like a flat, so it's like a point, and I felt like when I picked it up, it laid it down okay, but I felt like it was a little like
it's
I
hard to stamping, blend.
But then it's like, it's so
stiff.
What are you? I'm not doing this.
Yes.
Like, I don't understand. So I would have liked to see a fluffier blush brush. I don't know.
Because I love their foundation brush, but I would skip the
tools and
the blush and bronzer blush.
Yeah.
Alrighty, guys, that's it. That's all the new makeup we bought / PR. Let us know now that the video has come to an end what you want us to review, what you want us to talk about, out what you're intrigued by, and we'll talk about it in some way, shape, or form. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe to this channel. We have new videos every single week. Make sure to subscribe to the Beautiful Unbothered podcast. We have new videos every single Sunday on YouTube and streaming on Monday. Wherever you are, we hope you are happy, safe, and healthy. And remember,
you are beautiful.
Bye.